Hi, my name is Helene Hendriksen, PhD student at the Alzheimer's Center Amsterdam. In this presentation, I will present clinicians, patients, and care partners' evaluation of ADAPTS using the Think Out Loud method. These are the disclosures of the Alzheimer's Center Amsterdam. ADAPTS is a web-based tool to support memory clinic professionals in interpreting and discussing results of diagnostic testing with patients and care partners, and making decisions about diagnostic testing together. You can take a look at ADAPT by visiting the website www.adapt.health. ADAPT harbors modules both aimed at clinicians as well as patients and care partners. If you're interested in the development of the different modules of ADAPT, I refer you to the articles of my colleagues Agneta Fruytier and Ingrid van Maurik. You can find the references below. We can define different phases in the development of ADAPT. And as you can see in the figure, in each phase of the developing process of ADAPT, different methods were applicable. So we use focus groups, panels, interviews, and usability pilots. And in all these methods, with the exception of literature search, the end users of our tool were involved. So clinicians, patients, and care partners co-created the tool. And this is an important aspect because a non-consideration of users' preferences during the development of a tool may ultimately lead to a non-effective tool. So in phase three in the blue square, we had our research prototype. And eventually, our next goal was to build a demonstration version of ADAPT that can be tested in clinical practice. But before we could do that, we needed a method to get over the so-called teething troubles, so the difficulties you experience in the early stages of a project. And to that end, we used Think Out Loud sessions. So what is the Think Out Loud method? In the Think Out Loud method, you let end users say out loud what comes to mind while performing a certain task. In this way, we gain further insight into the possible questions and obstacles that ADAPT raises, and these can be used for final improvements of the prototype. So the task was to prepare a fictional patient's consultation with the tools available at ADAPT that are directed towards that end user. We included 10 clinicians, 6 patients, and 1 partner. We used qualitative content analysis, and we labeled the comments that the end users made as positive, negative, neutral, or ambiguous. And then we divided the comments into a category. So does the comment relate to design and presentation, content and information, or navigation and structure? So we concluded that ADAPT fulfills a need, and further improvements include adjustments regarding navigation and structure and design and presentation. And we experienced that the Think Out Loud method is a useful method as a step between the prototype and demonstration version, because we had the ability to gain feedback in a structured way. And this leads to other insights than when we would have immediately started gaining feedback in the unstructured clinical practice. So what's next? Well, we're moving forward, and currently we are testing feasibility in Dutch memory clinics. And afterwards, we plan to do a European randomized control trial to test effectiveness of ADAPT. Please do not hesitate to send me an email if you're interested in participating, or if you have any other questions. Thank you all for watching my presentation. I would like to thank the ADAPT team, my colleagues, and all participating clinicians, patients, and care partners for their efforts.